You saw the press conferences, you saw the information coming in. If you want to kind of talk about maybe the moment or moments when you started kind of thinking, wait, this isn't the truth, or wait, this isn't the full story.
It's funny. I mean, I'm a classic skeptical journalist who sees blood in the water and all my piranha instincts come out. I consider myself an equal opportunity muckraking journalist. I don't care if it's a Democrat or Republican, supposedly a good guy, a bad person. If someone's not telling the truth, if they're hurting other people, I'm going to tell that story. So I remember being called in the very first weeks of after the government had raided Fisher homes and mass arrested many people. And I was really worried about how I was going to handle this because I was not committed to believing that Fisher Homes was not fully capable of doing the things that the government had accused them of doing. And I guess what really swayed me, the first thing that swayed me was my very first meeting with Henry Fisher, because he looked me in the eye and says, I'm going to be an open book and we're going to be an open book to you because we want to tell this story as it is. You have absolute free access to any person here. You have open access to any document that we have, and your role is to use every journalistic instinct that you have and tell the story as it is. I don't get that usually from my editors, let alone from someone who's going to be the subject of scrutiny and might come out, on the negative side of the judgment calendar and something like that. So that really opened me up to at least being sympathetic that there could be two sides to the story. And in fact, there are many sides to the story.
As far as the government, I guess, what kind of relationship did you have with them, if any? I mean, were they open to speaking with you? Were they open to sharing their side of the story?
The government was very closed on this. They really operated through press releases, news conferences, and they held things very close to the vest. And even to this day, they will not admit that they bungled the case, though the evidence suggests it overwhelmingly, and the fact that the charges are not being pursued at this point, I think, speaks volumes about how poorly the government handled their case. But I think what happened was very, very early on, after the raid, the government recognized that it had blundered. The lead prosecutor on this, I think, hoped beyond hope that he could bully Henry Fisher and Fisher Homes into a quick plea bargain, close the books on this, walk away with a victory, promote his career. Show great progress in Washington about how this issue is being done and so forth. But day by day, as the case unfolded, the holes in the government's case got larger and larger and larger, and the hole that they dug for themselves got deeper and deeper, and they became less and less willing to be open and frank about what the case really was all about and the missteps that they had made.